He appeared to him and told him he was to destroy personally Israel in America. And when he did, he would arise to power. Islam says that the Mahdi will rule from the Temple Mount. Wake up, the world! The Messiah of Islam is the Antichrist of Christianity who will rule from the Temple Mount. Ahmadinejad claims the Egyptian riots is the Iran says the end of the world has arrived. Inside of this video, which is in the box, this video shows that the Iranian regime believes that the chaos is divine proof that their ultimate victory is at hand. It's called The Coming is Near, and it describes the current events in the Middle East, that is the introduction to the entrance of this mythical, magical Mahdi. This Messiah figure, who in the Islamic scriptures say it will lead the armies of the Islamic people to victory over all of the Muslims in the last days. President Ahmadinejad, who in this video says will conquer Jerusalem prior to the Mahdi's, they're trying to force this to come to pass. Now, you cannot force God's hand in any way, but God will allow man to destroy himself. And I'm telling you that man is trying to make all this come to pass. And toward the end of this video, you're going to be amazed at some things that are going on. Now, the Vatican wants secession or Catholic occupation over Jerusalem as well. There was a secret agreement signed in December 1993 between the Holy See and Israel to hand over the old city to the Vatican. In 1994, this was published on the front page of a newspaper, and it was sent in the form of a telegram to the Rome Embassy and to Jerusalem Foreign Ministry. Now, the Vatican has always wanted to claim the Temple Mount. They will try everything they can to gain full control. We were told by Alberto Rivera how the Catholic Church wanted to gain full control of the Temple Mount and why. This is one of the Vatican's big desires. All of this is about to play out, and you will see in this video as it unwinds, and the division, why there is going to be three divisions in the United States. We all know the Bible tells us of the building of the third temple. Well, the Temple Institute now has all the furniture and the priestly garments ready for the third temple. All that's missing is the Ark of the Covenant. And the temple will be built in less than a year when they get the go-ahead. They've already made sacrifice of animals near the temple site in 1998 and other times and other locations. The rabbinical priests have been handpicked. But the good news is, of all this, the Ark of the Covenant was found in 1982 by Ron Wyatt. I know a lot of you don't believe that. But I've done a lot of research. I've watched every video this man ever made, all of his writings up to his deathbed. Everything is done in God's timing, and no man can change it. The third temple does not have to be a building. I wrestled with this in my spirit over and over, and it has made a delay with me making this video until I had complete, total peace about this in my spirit. But all they need is a tent or a structure like this with all the courts. And then the daily sacrifice will resume as it is spoken of in the Bible for this time. As soon as they implement the mark upon us, the Ark of the Covenant, as the angel told Ron, will be released for the beginning of the building. And trust me, they will begin to sacrifice, for the red heifer is ready, and they've just been biting at the bit to commit this abomination against our Lord that they do not really understand. This reads Palestine's preferred peace treaty with Israel by September of this year. Israel and Palestinians have agreed with President Barack Obama's target of September of 2011 for a peace agreement. A date was endorsed by the European Union and much of the world, according to this article. Second, the two-year program to build the infrastructure of a Palestinian state will be complete, and the Palestinians hope the second thirds of the 152 UN member state will have recognized the Palestinians. Remember when Hu was here? They not only flew the Chinese flag then, but also the PLO flag on the White House lawn. Are you starting to wake up now? Well, wait a minute, it's too late. As I'm working on this, it is the 14th day of May, and the police in Jerusalem have begun to block off parts of the city to the Jews, where they once before had the freedom to drive and move around in, as this article below says. Jerusalem is already ours, with the Palestinian leaders saying that the eastern half of the holy city is already in their hands. They have new textbooks denying the Jews the rights to live in Israel, teaching more hate and division. This new article is titled, Obama's Plan, the Temple Mount under Arab Muslim Sovereignty. The link for these articles are below in the box. I have a friend who came running into us as we were working one day at the church. He had a very strange look on his face, and he began to tell he and his wife had a dream of a man and his wife. They were signing the peace treaty with Israel, and he looked at their faces, but he didn't know who they were. It was before the political race for the president had begun in 2007. He had just seen the two of them on an ad on TV when Obama announced he was running for office. Cold chills began to run up and down all of our backs and necks as he told about their dreams. Well, here we are today with Obama speaking of signing this peace treaty. I tell you, I have confirmation for all these dreams and all these visions of two or more of what I'm about to share with you that I have been leading up to. In this room, I have been shown all puppets. They're being controlled by the real ones that control the events behind the scenes. I would not want to be in this room. You could not pay me enough money to see the splitting of God's holy land and the signing away of what they plan that Wadi said not to touch. Every man in there has sold their soul out. There will be so many demons in that room. I would not even want to work near them. The head person is controlled by the Vatican. We all know him well. He thinks he sits so tall above them all. There is never a paper sign that he is not there to put the holy seal upon. But he is not only holy, but very far from it, or he would not even think about being there. The first seat in the captain chair is from the Vatican. To the right of him sits the president. To the left, leader of Saudi Arabia. To the right, the leader of Egypt. To the left, Britain. To the right, another leader of the United States. To the left, the leader of France. To the right, a past leader of the United States. To the left, a leader of Syria. To the right, the president of Iran. I know their names, but there's no need to call them out. And this is what they have all agreed to do. The top quarter of Israel will be divided, and then the rest of Israel will be cut in half. And then they will take Jerusalem and cut it in half. The upper half will belong to the Palestinians. They will have complete control of the Temple Mount. area to themselves. This is what I've been seeing and I have confirmation on. I also know at this time Israel is ready to strike upon Iran. There's a link to this below in the box. And now let's have a look at what God's word has to say. Let's look in Zechariah 12 and 3. And in that day I will make Jerusalem a burdensome stone to all the people, and all that burden themselves, it shall be cut to pieces, and all the people of the earth will be gathered together against it. Zechariah 12 and 9. And it shall come to pass in that day I will seek to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem. Zechariah 14 and 3. Then Yahweh will go out and fight against those nations, and he fights in that day of a battle. Zechariah 12 and 2. And behold, I will make Jerusalem a cup of trouble unto all the people around about them. And when they shall be in the siege both against Judea and against Jerusalem. And his word is true. And all of his promises are yes and amen. And I have been shown that we're going to have a great earthquake in the United States in the middle because of all this. And I've been saying this for a while, making videos on it. And many of you do not want to agree with me and you want to say it's a harp. So go ahead and keep saying it. But every time there's a meeting for peace in Israel, you can look it up. I'm not going to look it up for you anymore. But for confirmation for what I've been saying, let's have a look at a prophecy that Dave Wilkerson said. The title of this is Earthquakes Coming to the United States. And he said, the United States is going to experience in a not so distant future a most tragic earthquake in its history. One day soon, this nation will be reeling under an impact of the biggest news story of modern times. It will coverage of the biggest, most dangerous earthquake of its history. It will cause widespread panic and fear. Without a doubt, it will become one of the most completely reported earthquakes ever. Television news will suspend all programming and carry all day coverage. And then he said, this is from chapter 2 in Dave Wilkerson's 1974 book titled The Vision. Another earthquake, possibly in Japan, will precede one that I see coming here. And I'm going to say, this is Ruby. Jack and I have been talking. Japan will have another devastating earthquake that can completely flatten the northern part of Japan. There is not the slightest doubt in my mind about this forthcoming massive earthquake in our continent. I am not at all convinced that this earthquake will take place in California. In fact, I believe it's going to take place where it is least expected. This terrible earthquake may happen in an area that not known as an earthquake belt. It will be so high on the Richter scale that it will trigger two other major earthquakes. And then on March 2009, Dave posted, an earth-shattering calamity is about to happen. It is going to be so frightening, we are all going to tremble, even the godliest among us. For 10 years, I've been warning about 1,000 fires coming to New York. It will engulf the whole megaplex. I'm including New Jersey and Connecticut. Major fires across America will experience riots and blazing fires such as we saw in Wyatt's, New Jersey years ago. There will be riots, fires, and cities worldwide. There will be looting, including Times Square, New York City. What we are experiencing now is not a recession.